So, hi everyone, this is Vrinda here. Welcome to my YouTube channel, and today I am having an unboxing of my new card deck for all of you. As you can see, the beautiful Krishna Consciousness deck that is here. I just received this deck yesterday and it was such a surprise. It was to come to me somewhere in November end, but just out of the blue, the courier guy appeared and he gave me this deck. And today on the Sharad Purnima energies, I'm unboxing this card because I just could not wait. I was so excited and such a beautiful message from the universe by getting me this card on Sharad Purnima. So let's open up the cards and see what cards are there, and then at the end of it I will give you guys a reading, also a one card message. This reading would apply to anyone watching this video whenever. It's an evergreen reading, it's not just time based. So whenever you see this, whenever you hear this video, whenever you see the cards, the message will come to you from Krishna. So let's begin and unbox the beautiful deck. What a beauty. Here is the little book along with it, which will have some explanations of the cards. I just love the coloring that they've done. I just love the image that they've created. It's the same image on the card, but I just love also having the same image. I quite like the artwork that's been done here. As it is, I have a very special affiliation to Krishna. I just love his energy, his images. And you see, nothing here was really thought about and planned. When I was just laying to do this card reading also, I just took a, because this cloth also was a new one, and I was just looking at three elements to keep, and I picked the conch shell and the evil eye and the bell. Now when I see just the colors, the way they are going with everything, you see the white here, the blue here, this blue, the colors, it's so amazing. And like I always keep saying, there's nothing like a coincidence in the universe. So let me hear, and we open the deck. You see it's all packed here, it's sealed. Open that, let me throw this away. And yeah, the cards have this image of the peacock feather. What a beauty, so beautiful. This is so beautiful. And these are all the cards that I see. So now they are, it was a sealed pack, so it's all in order. And I'm going to just show you guys all the cards. So it's a 44 cards deck, and I'll show you guys all the cards, what they are, and then in the end we'll get some reading for ourselves. Now if you look at this, let me just tell you guys the name of the author also. She's Ashita Saxena. Ashita Saxena, and her little brief introduction has been given. She is a counselor, tarot reader, writer and certified paranormal investigator with expertise in Reiki, aura reading, chakra cleansing and many other alternate therapies. She is the one who's created this deck, and I'm so grateful to her. So much gratitude for her. I have not known her, I don't know anything about her, it's just I love the deck and I had ordered for it. Also, I would like to make it very clear, this is something I'm doing very personally, as a personal choice. I'm not affiliated to any marketing team or anybody, and I'm not like a part of any promotional thing for anyone. It's my connection with Krishna and my connection with the card readings, and all must have seen that how much I love doing card readings. That's why these unboxing videos I'm starting to create, so that I can contribute to you guys, whoever is looking at what these cards are all about. So let's just look at all the 44 cards. If you see here, the first card is Help is on the way. Purity. Knock knock. Time to move on. Pay time. Your call will be answered. Time to relax. Protection. Flow with the rhythm. Divine darshan. Belief. Let go of false ego. patience, share your boundaries, be positive, surrender, be open, be humble, change of place, presence of mind, death, let your inner beauty shine, make the right choice, ask for God's grace and help, stay connected within, Gita, the absolute truth, the joy of friendship, respect, new creation, do not provoke negativity, leave for now, charity, abundance, tough times, eternal bond, do your karma, true devotion and faith, blessings, divine blessings, new beginning, selection, transformation, law of karma, the end. So it is so beautiful the way the images have been created. Each artwork is so beautiful. Each card is so nice. Very nicely rounded edges of the cards. They don't hurt you at all. And I love the way what they've done is from Krishna's life, they've picked up chapters. They've taken some of his stories and then created messages from that. So like, you know, like when they're telling about transformation or when they're talking about eternal bond, or when they are talking about be humble, they are actually showing some imagery of Krishna's life, and from that they're asking you to, like, you know, getting you the message. So it's going to be such a beautiful thing to include these cards in my readings when I'm giving you guys messages. It'll be so clear and crisp to know what they are, you know, what the messages are coming to us. And I'm sure the book has a little bit explanation to each thing. Let's see how it is. Now let's see. Now supposing if it is, help is on the way. So here they have given a little bit of description. Devaki and Vasudev waited for a long time for their son to return. They prayed every day for him and his well-being. Krishna killed Kansa and went to free his parents. He himself wanted to do so. You will get answers to all your questions. Do not worry. You will soon receive help. So you see, like I told you guys, looking at the images, it felt as if they picked up things from Krishna's life. And when I read this, do you get that? It's like they're actually picking that up. They're actually, like, you know, talking about his life story or how that card is. And then they're giving the message. Wow, I love this. This is so nice. They explain that part and then in the end they give you that message. Connect with the divine and you sit quietly, close your eyes and calm your mind. You will get answers to all your troubling questions. Wonderful, wonderful, wonderful. I'm so happy to have this card deck and I'm so happy I'll be able to contribute to you guys with this. So now time for a message for us, you know, time for a reading. So let's do a quick reading. A, which is the conch shell. This is the group B, which is the bell. This is the group C, which is the eagle eye. So just concentrate on these cards. Concentrate on these three images. Look at the conch shell and the card. Look at the bell. Look at the eagle eye. And just think of any that one question or any message that you would like to receive from Krishna. I think you can surrender to him and just say, okay, Krishna, I'm willing to receive whatever message you want to give me. Or you can ask him, okay, this one issue is coming to my awareness and I would like to get some more answers to that, or maybe some clarity on that, and focus on that. And then close your eyes and just concentrate on the three images, the three elements here, the conch shell, the bell and the evil eye, and pick one. Pick whatever you resonate with and then we'll open up the cards. So now that you have made your choice, we'll start to look at the cards. So now let's open up the cards and then see what shows up. This is the card A. Lovely. So what I see here is the Draupadi Chidharan in the image, and the message that's coming is ask for God's grace and help. When in trouble, ask for help, the necessary help will come to you. I mean, to me this definitely looks like that, that Krishna's hand is coming here. If you see this image, Krishna's hand is coming here and you know they are trying to pull his, her dress. So yes, looks like this Draupadi Chidharan image to me. And we all know how she had called out for Krishna and he had come to help her. So all the group A people who are looking at this and who picked up the conch shell and who looked at this card, for them the message is loud and clear. Ask for help. Pray and ask for help, you know, whatever it is. Don't have your ego come in between, or don't think I'm brave enough or strong enough to handle everything. Don't go into the space that where you feel that everything can be tackled by you yourself. You have to do things which, you know, whatever is required to get you out of that space, go for it. Ask people for help. Don't let your pride or ego come in. Even let's look at the book and see what it is telling us. So ask for help. And I figured in this book, it's nothing in order. They've not gone in like any alphabetical order or any number sequence, and they don't even have an index here. So I really had to rummage through the book to get this, where it is given, you know, where this card is, and I got it on page 47. But like I said, there is no sequence, so that could be a little tricky. And like I said, when you start doing more and more of readings, you don't even need the book. It's only the first time probably that, you know, you require to read a little bit from there. So once you get the hang of the cards and once you start connecting, I don't even look at the book once I'm doing my readings. Every time the deck is new, I just take a look at the book and see what the cards are talking about. And like what I told you about here, this is what this ask for God's grace and help. I'll just read you what is written here. Once Krishna accidentally hurt his finger with the Sudarshan Chakra and blood started oozing out, Draupadi was there at that time. Without waiting for a second, she tore her strip from her sari and tied Krishna's finger with it. When the Pandavas lost Draupadi in the game of dice, she was pulled by her hair into the court by Dushasan, brother of Duryodhana. Duryodhana then shamelessly asked Dushasan to disrobe her. Draupadi, feeling helpless, prayed to Lord Krishna. Krishna was not present in the court, but by his grace, as Dushasan pulled her sari, it grew longer and longer, and at last he was exhausted and fell on the ground tired. Just then the queen mother of Duryodhana entered and asked her husband to end this. When in trouble, ask for help, the necessary help will come to you. So these ending messages are all that they are written in the card also. And like I told you guys, I also sense this is the Draupadi Chidharan. That's what the book also talks about. Okay, so basically group A message for you is ask for help when required. Now we'll go to the group B, which is the bell. Let's see what message is coming to the group B. Flow with the rhythm. Allow all the things to take their rightful positions on their own so that they can together produce the same effect. Do not judge anything, but flow with the tide. What I'm loving about these cards is the messages are very, very, very loud and clear. Like, you know, if you're looking to get some answers, if you're in a space where you would like some guidance to come by, it's very beautiful and simply given. The guidance is so clear. Flow with the rhythm, basically just be in allowance. No judgments, no conclusions, no coming to a space that this is how it should be, this is how I want it, not giving any script to the universe. Do your action and then after that let it just happen and let it fall in place. So if group B, if it's coming to you guys, probably the people out here in group B, many of you are kind of control freaks, or who try to really control the outcomes, or before you start something, you're always looking at things that how will they end, or you know, what is the result going to be. So you're always vested in the outcome more, and you're always looking at what things can, you know, what you can get out of this investment, or this class, or this workshop, or this relationship, or this outing. So whenever you're planning something, you're always looking what is going to be the end result. So basically the message that's coming for you is flow with the rhythm. don't get stuck in the logics, don't get stuck in the space that no, this is how it should be. And if probably you all are not like that in group B, like I said, it's a general reading, so just pick what resonates to you, which doesn't, just let it go. It's not like a specific personal reading, it's more of a group reading. So if maybe all of you are not like that, but maybe the situation that you're asking about, somewhere you're playing in that space, you know, somewhere you're not being able to let go of the whole thing and you're getting a little too vested in the outcome. You're not being able to let go of just following the energy. So probably if it's about a situation, follow this guidance that Krishna is giving you, flow with the rhythm. The image that I see here is about churning the butter, like the, probably it's Mother Yashoda who's churning the butter. Now let's look at the book, what it says, flow with the rhythm. Like I said, the only thing about this thing as of now in this whole deck is kind of put off to me is this having no index or no alphabetical order to the whole card setup in the book. Now everything I have to just, you know, scram through the whole book to find out. I got the flow with the rhythm. Yeah, it is Mother Yashoda. So whenever Mother Yashoda was free, she would churn butter for her son, singing about him and his activities. The sound of her melodious voice, tinkling of her bangles, the sound of churning and her hard work created a serene environment in the house. Time flew as Mother Yashoda and all the occupants in the house witnessed her unselfish love. Allow all the things to take their rightful positions on their own so that they can together produce the same effect. Do not judge anything but flow with the tide. Somewhere I also sense that the group B people, there's a strong message coming to them regarding their mother. Probably your mother is on your mind. There's something about your mother that's playing on your mind, maybe about their health or maybe your relationship with them, or you know, like something has been troubling you regarding your mother. And if you just take this advice and just follow along, follow the energy, probably just going to all work it out by itself. You don't really have to worry too much about it. The energy of the mother here is totally of, you know, giving and loving without any expectation. So whatever the thing is coming up, I'm sure you can follow this guidance and clear it up. So now we will look at the C card, the evil eye. So all the people who got connected to the evil eye card, let's see what message is coming to them. This card is divine blessings. This card indicates the unending flow of divine blessings and fulfillment of spiritual goals. Beautiful. And I sense it's the image of Radha and Krishna on the swing and having a moment of happiness with each other. Total happiness of looking at each other and surrendering to each other. So it's a beautiful message, Group C, to all of you, saying that there's an unending flow of divine blessings and fulfillment of your spiritual goals coming your way. How beautiful is that? And somewhere I also sense maybe the Group B, Group C people are getting this message regarding their some personal relationship, and mostly a romantic relationship or their marriage, or you know, getting married or getting a life partner. So anyone who is looking to get married and who is into that space and has connected with the card C, I sense that, you know, it might show up very soon for them. Let's see what the little book says about this card, the divine blessings. Here is the divine blessings card. So here we can read about the divine blessings. Krishna married Princess Rukmini, who herself was the reincarnation of Goddess Lakshmi. The presence of both Krishna and Rukmini is a divine blessing. So yeah, the image is not Radha, it's Rukmini, but yes, it's about a love relationship, marriage. So what I sensed about the card indicating a marriage sense was there, but yeah, we are talking about Rukmini here, not Radha. And yeah, actually, if you look at it, Krishna was never really married to Radha. The marriage happened with Rukmini, and the sense of marriage came very strongly to me in this card. Krishna married Princess Rukmini, who herself was a reincarnation of Goddess Lakshmi. The presence of both Krishna and Rukmini is a divine blessing. Rukmini was the daughter of Bhishmaka, the king of Vidarbha. She fell in love with Krishna and longed to marry him. Rukmani's parents were happy about this, but Rukmani, her brother, strongly opposed it. Rukmi wanted her to be married to his friend. Rukmani was horrified and sent for a Brahmin, Sunanda, whom she trusted, and asked him to deliver a letter to Krishna. She asked Krishna to come to Vidarbha and kidnap her to avoid a battle. Krishna came and took her away. At Dwarka, Krishna was married to Rukmini with great pomp and show. This card indicates the unending flow of divine blessings and fulfillment of spiritual goals. You know guys, it's so interesting that I'm watching this Mahabharata on Hotstar these days, and yesterday night the episode that I saw was all about Krishna kidnapping Rukmini and how they get married. So this is like something really amazing for me to this card to show up today. And like I said, Group C definitely about marriage, you know, a lot about marriage. And if some of you who are not connecting with that marriage part, just concentrate on the message that it's saying, that it is indicating an unending flow of divine blessings and fulfillment of spiritual goals. So beautiful messages to all of you. Group A is all about asking for help, and it's about your personal aspect much more. Group B is all about flowing with the energy and just following what shows up, and has a lot of mother energy and feminine energy to the message. And here we have, like, you know, the blessings are already on the way, and it's all about the attraction love, the marriage love, and, you know, the romantic love. So beautifully, the three, you can see the three messages are quite nicely demarcated into different messages. They are very loud and clear, and I hope you guys have resonated. Whatever has connected to you, let me know. You can leave your comments in the comment section. Whatever seemed to you, which is coming for you, just let me know what aspect of the reading resonated. And I'm planning to do a lot more of these unboxing videos and create many of these little readings for you guys. And let's see what it opens up for all of you and what messages start coming to you. And as you all know, I do have a broadcast list on WhatsApp, and in that every month at least two or three single card or two card readings I keep giving to everyone at a very, very nominal price, because I have a very strong guidance from my angels that these little guidances and readings this year are going to contribute to people quite a bit. Because people are having a lot of transformation in this year 2020, and as the spiritual awareness is growing, as the consciousness and awareness is coming up, these kind of cards and these kind of readings give us a lot more understanding of what all can be done for our choices. So this is the Krishna Consciousness deck once again. Like, you know, let me show you guys. This is the Krishna Consciousness deck of 44 cards created by Ashita Saxena, and luckily, fortunately, lovingly received on Sharad Purnima day by me. And yes, my name says it all, Tulsi Guidance, Vrinda. I'm such a huge, huge, huge fan of Krishna. Most of you know that. And I can't even tell you the blessing it is feeling to me at this point when I'm doing this unboxing and this reading for you guys. It definitely gets into the category of one of my favorite decks. And I will be using it a lot to create more and more different sorts of readings for you guys. Stay connected with me on WhatsApp. My WhatsApp number is 900-4900-777. Yeah, the ending is 777. Once again, the number is 900-4900-777. I'm based in Bombay, and you guys can send me a message and get added to my broadcast list for all these little readings that I keep doing. Along with that, I do have many other aspects in Tulsi Guidance also. So once you join me, you'll come to know about those also. And most importantly, subscribe to my channel. Keep coming back. I'll keep posting these videos. You can always do the subscription there, and you'll always get the notification whenever I post a new video. Not only unboxing of cards, I plan to even add a lot of healing tips and all on my channel. Anything you guys would like to see on this channel, anything you feel could be more contributing, please come back to me and give me a comment. I mean, you can write in the comment section. You can even send me a WhatsApp text, or you can write in the comment section here. And please go ahead and share this with whoever you feel is a Krishna lover, whoever you feel can benefit from this reading of Krishna, whoever can enjoy the message coming from Krishna, please go ahead and share the video with them. Thank you so much for being here. Thank you so much for watching. And until next time, Jai Shri Krishna.